This is Pradeep Chaudhary. Today I am going to explain about present continuous tense. In the last class I completed simple present. Now today I am going to explain about present continuous tense. If you see the structure of present continuous tense, subject plus am, is, are plus V for plus object. So S means subject here. Am, is, are helping verbs, are be forms. So V4 means we can write as a V1 plus inform. V1 plus inform is equal to V4, or V4 is equal to V1 plus inform, and O for the object. If you see the subject definition of the present continuous tense, we can use in a four ways. So first way is to express an action, activity going on, continuing at the time of speaking. So at the time of speaking, if any action is in a continuous process, then we can use present continuous tense. For example, right now at the time of speaking, I am explaining English grammar. Right now I am explaining English grammar. So it is in the process of the continuous. So any action or any activity, it is going on at the time of speaking, those are known as the present continuous tense. That means we can use in a present continuous tenses. So this is the first rule of present continuous tenses, or first usage of present continuous tenses. If you see the example, I am reading English. Someone came to our class and he asked me, "What you are doing?" I said, "I am reading English." At the time of speaking, what I am doing? I am reading English grammar. My action is in a continuous process. My activity is in a continuous process. That's why I used in a present continuous tense. And next example, she is cleaning the room. So when I entered into the room, she is cleaning the room. At the time of speaking, what she is doing? She is cleaning the room. So here, our action is in the form of the continuous. Our activity is in the form of the continuous. So we use in a present continuous tense. So it is barking. When I entered into another neighbor's house, in that house, dog is there. When the dog saw me, immediately the dog started barking. Now the dog is barking. So it is in the form of the continuous. They are playing cricket. So if you see a few students who are present outside of the class, they are playing cricket. Right now, at the time of speaking, still they are playing. So all these examples refers to present continuous tense, because every example is in the form of the continuous action, or that activity is going on, or any action is going on. So at that time we have to use in a present continuous tense. Second rule, to express a temporary action which may not be happening at the time of speaking. So this is at the time of speaking. Now this rule is, at the time of speaking, the action is not going on. In a first rule, at the time of speaking, the action is going on. But in a second rule, at the time of speaking, the action is not going on. Even though we can use in a present continuous tense. For example, he is searching for a job. At the time of speaking, he is not searching for the job. But his duty is searching for the job. That means he went to Hyderabad to join in any another company. For that purpose, he is searching for a job. But at the time of speaking, he is not searching for the job. But his duty is searching for the job. Another example. I am reading The Wings of Fire. At the time of speaking, I am not reading. But before only I started. What? Reading The Wings of Fire. So this is different to first rule. In a first rule, at the time of speaking, the action is going on. In a second rule,
at the time of speaking, the action is not going up. Even though we can use in a present continuous tense. So if you go for the thought rule, for an action that has already been arranged to take place in the near future, that means in a future we decided to do something in the future, near future, not long future, near future. Those type of actions also we can use in a present continuous tense. For example, we are going to the park this evening. Right now, at the time of speaking, we are not going, but we decided to go to the park at the evening time, not now. That means we are talking at the morning time. At the morning time only, for example, today, in the early morning, me and my friend, we discussed, and we decided that, alright, today evening, we must go to park. In that way, we decided in the early morning. So, it is the action already we prepared and arranged in the near future. So, in that cases also, we can use in a present continuous tense. Once again, we are going to the park this evening. That means we are not going at the time of speaking. We will go. When we will go? At the evening time. So, still time is there. It is near future. So, we can use in a present continuous tense. Another example. My uncle is arriving tomorrow. By the time of speaking, he is not arriving. But he will arrive by tomorrow. By tomorrow, 5 o'clock, he will be there. That means my uncle is arriving tomorrow. By tomorrow, he will come to my house. So, it is a planned future. So, most probably, we used to speak regarding the trains, aeroplanes and buses and so on. When we are in the journey, we used to use this kind of the method. We used to ask somebody else, when your father will come? My father will come by tomorrow. That means already this action was planned. So, we can use these kinds of the planned actions which is very very near to future, we can use in a present continuous tenses. And the next one is to express a future action with going to. That means to express a future action with going to. Place V1. I am going to join in the school shortly. That means you are going to. Going to is nothing but it is going to express. The action is going to be start. So, in that cases also we can use in a present continuous tense. If you see the example, I am going to join in this school shortly. What I am saying here, I am going to join in this school. Right now I didn't join in this school. But in a future I am going to join in this school. I decided that I am going to join in this school. So, your going to also refers to near future. So, at the time also we can use in a present continuous tense. When going to is there, immediately you have to use V1. Main verb V1. Going to plus main verb V1. So, here I am going to join. Your going to plus V1. Join. So, this is called soon, in near future, shortly, he is going to join. I am going to market. That means right now I am not going, but I will go in a near future. So, in this way, we can use. So, these are the four methods, four usages, we can use the present continuous tense to express all these four types of the actions, our attitudes, our ideas in the present continuous tenses. And another example, she is not going to participate in the competition. So today, right now, we are going to conduct one competition. Otherwise, we started to conduct a competition. Now in that competition, she is not going to participate in that competition. Right now, she is not participating. But she decided that she is not going to participate in the competition.
So it is in the near future. Already she was decided not to participate in that competition. And if you see time frames, now we speaking at the time of speaking, that means in a present continuous form only. Nowadays also it is related to continuous tense. These days, at present, at right now, at the moment, right now, listen, look, see, hear, stop. All these main verbs, these are not main verbs, but all these words are talking about, and it refers to present continuous tenses. So if you are going to see these words in a given sentences, then you can identify very easily that these sentences belongs to present continuous tenses. So if you are going to see these words in a given sentences, if you see those sentences in a competitive exams or in a public examinations, you can identify very easily that these belongs to present continuous tenses. Okay, by seeing these words in a given sentences, you can decide that these sentences belongs to present continuous tenses. Next, if you see this structure once again, subject plus am, is, are plus V4 plus object. V4 is equal to V1 plus inform. It is a positive structure for the present continuous tenses. And a negative structure for the present continuous tense is subject plus amen, aren't, isn't plus V1 plus inform plus object. It is the negative structure for the present continuous tense. And if you see yes or no question, am, or, is, plus, subject plus, V1 plus, inform plus, object. So this is yes or no questions. In yes or no negative, that means this one is interrogative question. In interrogative question, second model is yes or no question. So in yes or no questions, again this structure is a negative one. Amen, aren't, isn't, plus, subject plus, V1 plus, inform plus, object. So these are the four possible structures for present continuous tenses. So in a present continuous tenses, we can say positive sentences, negative sentences, yes or no questions, and yes or no negative questions. So in a four ways we can use this present continuous tenses in the form of these structures. If you see the examples, I am watching news. That means at the time of speaking, I am watching news. It is a positive sentence. Second one, I am not watching news. So it is a negative statement. Am I watching news? It is a yes or no question. Am I watching news? It is a yes or no question. And next one, am and I watching news? Yes or no? Negative questions. So these are the examples for these four structures. And if you see here, for subject I, we have to use am. I is a first person singular. So we have to use be form am in present continuous tense. Third person singular is he, she, it. We have to use is, is. And first person plural we. Second person singular you. Second person plural you. And third person plural they. For these subjects we have to add are. So these are the helping verbs to use different type of the subjects. So in a public examinations, in a competitive examinations, they will ask you. By seeing these helping verbs, you have to add the subject. Otherwise, by seeing the subject, you have to add the helping verb. If the subject is singular, singular helping verb. If the subject is plural,
plural helping verb. So if any regarding one name also, for example, Raju is. So a Raju is third person singular. At the time we can say Raju is, Ranu, Rani is. So if you are going to see two names, Raju and Rani. Now two nouns are there. These two nouns are connected with a connected word. So at the time you have to use plural helping verb because two nouns, plural. So you have to use plural helping verb. Raju and Rani are playing cricket. Two nouns, so plural. We have to use plural helping verb. So in this way, in a present continuous tenses, we can express our actions, ideas and everything in the form of the continuous process. By this one, we completed present continuous.